Let's take one example to verify periodicity of a signal. Determine whether the following signals are periodic. If they are periodic, find fundamental period. Here x of t is equal to cos 2 pi t plus sin 3 t. So here x of t is sum of two signals. We supposed to verify whether the signal is periodic or not. If it is periodic, we supposed to calculate fundamental period. So the first step is we supposed to calculate the fundamental period of each signal. So here this is the first signal, that is x1 of t. Let this be second signal, that is x2 of t. We'll find t1, that is fundamental period for the first signal. So here omega 1 is equal to 2 pi, because we can represent signal as cos omega t. So omega is equal to 2 pi. We know that omega is nothing but 2 pi f1, which is equal to 2 pi. Therefore f1 equal to 1 hertz. Therefore t1 is equal to reciprocal of frequency, that is 1 second. So this is fundamental period of first signal. So with respect to this signal, we have omega 2 is equal to 3. Therefore 2 pi f2 is equal to 3. Therefore f2 is equal to 3 divided by 2 pi. Therefore t2 is equal to reciprocal of f2, that is 2 pi by 3 seconds. So this is fundamental period of second signal, that is sin 3t. Let's proceed. In step 2, we are supposed to find the ratio of t1 and t2, that is t1 by t2 is equal to 1 divided by 2 pi by 3. I can write it as 3 by 2 pi. So here we can observe, here we have integer number and here we don't have integer. That is, this number is not a rational number. Therefore, the given signal is a periodic signal or non-periodic signal. That is, it's not a rational number. Therefore, given x of t is a periodic signal or non-periodic signal. Let's take another example. X of n is equal to cos 1 by 5 pi n sin 1 by 3 pi n. So here x of n, that is a discrete signal, is given. We supposed to verify whether it is periodic. If it is periodic, we supposed to calculate fundamental period. Here we can observe x of n is a product of signals. We'll try to convert this product term into sum term. We know that sin A cos B is equal to 1 over 2 sin A plus B plus sin A minus B. So now we'll try to express the same x of n in this form. Here we'll assume that this is A term and this is B term. So therefore I can represent it as 1 by 2 sin A is pi by 3 n, pi by 3 n plus B is pi by 5 n plus we have sin A is pi by 3 n minus pi by 5 n. So I can simplify this as equal to 1 by 2. So here I can get LCM will be 15, 5 pi n plus 3 pi n, that is 8 pi n plus this side we have sin. LCM is 15, 5 pi n minus 3 pi n, that is 2 pi n. So now x of n is also equal to 1 by 2 sin 8 pi by n 15 divided by 15 plus sin 2 pi n divided by 15. So now in this example, we can say omega 1 is equal to 8 pi by 15. In discrete signal, 2 pi into m by n. We know that in discrete signals, omega should be equal to 2 pi into m by n, where m by n are the integer numbers. So I will try to express this 8 by 15 in terms of 2 pi into m by n. This can be represented as 2 pi into 4 by 15, which is same as 8 pi by 15. So here we can observe that this m is 4 and n is 15, that is equal to m by n1, which is equal to 4 by 15. So therefore, the fundamental period of first signal, that is sine 8 pi by n 15, is n1 is equal to 15. Now similarly, we will find fundamental period of second signal, that is sine 2 pi n by 15. So here we have omega 2 is equal to 2 pi by 15, which can be expressed as 2 pi into, which is nothing but m by n2 is equal to 1 by 15. So here also n2 is equal to 15. That is fundamental period of second signal, that is n2 is equal to 15. So the next step is, we supposed to calculate the LCM of n1 and n2. That is the next step. Therefore, LCM of n1 and n2, that is 15 and 15, is equal to 15, which is nothing but L. So therefore, fundamental period n is equal to L, which is equal to 15. Therefore, this given signal is periodic and fundamental period is n is equal to 15. This is the solution for given problem. Thank you for watching.